Hey guys, so this is something I just finished here a few minutes ago. As you can tell by my voice, I'm still trying to fight off this thing that's eating me alive. I'm coming on the other side of it now, and so the fever's gone and everything. All that's left is my voice is shit and got a bit of a cough, but it was a pain in my butt. So it wasn't the flu or anything, it was just a really nasty cold. It was stubborn, and I decided I wanted to hang around and play. So this is the first time I've actually been able to really speak for a little bit, so I thought I'd wrap this thing up here. Yesterday I wrapped up my first entry into the Kursk, the 75th anniversary of Kursk group build. I couldn't speak at all yesterday, but so I was quite pleased with that one, and you guys seem to like it too. So I appreciate the comments on that one. That was really nice. And it's probably going to be maybe another few weeks before I start another one for the Curse Group build. I got a build that I want to do now that's has nothing to do with Battle Kursk. Actually, it's an airplane that I want to build. So I just want to do something different for a while. And then I'll start another build on the Battle of Kursk in probably a few weeks. So this thing here I just finished this morning. This was going to have actually a lot more figures on it than it was. Most of them, they were all going to be tank riders. They were all going to be on the tanks. And the reason why I chose to finish it now and use a few couple of different figures is the whole purpose of this diorama was to use up a couple of models that I had built a long time ago, but I still kind of liked them. But it was time to decide whether to turf them or recycle them to clear space on my shelf, which, you know, I'm always doing that. I need to make room for new work. So it was either throw them away or do something new with them. So this was my idea of do something new with them. I had a whole whack of these Russian figures that I wanted to see if I could use, and then I had these two tanks, the Is2 and the T-34-76, and both of them in winter camo. The 76, I could, it's an earlier 76, but there were still a couple of them still rolling around. They made so many of them, you know, and well, things being as they were, you know, anything was of use. So the scene's supposed to depict these two fellows rolling through a farmer's field past his house somewhere in Poland near the end of the war, probably like March of 45, maybe early April of 45. Still snow on the ground, still winterish, but just like maybe early spring. And so the infantry are cruising along with the tanks as they're supposed to be, and they're clearing houses and stuff like that as they're going, and they're about to do a breach and clear on this house. And what they don't know is there was a deployment of Fallschirmjäger in Poland in 45, and these are the last remnants of them hiding in the house. So there's going to be a little bit of a discussion, I guess, in a few minutes. There's like, I think, five Fallschirmjäger hiding in the house there. So and that was the point of the story. I was inspired by another build that I saw on Facebook to build this thing. I've seen different variants of that storyline where you have enemies on one side of a wall and, you know, or on either side of the wall, and they're about to encounter each other rather suddenly and surprisingly. And it's kind of a sort of a reoccurring theme sometimes with modelers, and it's a good one. I like it. It's a good story on it, lots of action and tension and drama and stuff. And it's good. I don't know, it gets you inspired, gets the juices flowing, it's exciting. And so I wanted to see if I could do something like that. And I came close, I think it's okay. But if I ever try to do it again, you know, there'd be things I'd do differently. Heighten the excitement kind of thing. I tried to make it look like there's a bit of action, like the T-34 is moving. I'm trying to make it look like it's, you know, there's actually motion a bit. And that the IS-2 has stopped. because there's a guy standing on it, and it's probably not a good idea to be standing on an IS-2 when it's moving like down the hill, especially in the casual manner he's standing in. And it would probably run over a bunch of fellas. And I got a couple of snipers, a sniper and a spotter, hiding in the grass over here, right? And they're, you know, with the infantry units and stuff, because they see, and then the tanks just happen to be passing through, kind of thing, as the infantry units were, you know, working their way through. So it's one incident occurring at the same time as another incident, just before this third incident is about to happen. So it's a typical diorama, layered format type thing. So the T-34-76 and the IS-2 are both very old builds that I decided I wanted to reuse in this. Several of these figures are also very, very old that I, you know, refurbished to try and bring them back to life. Some of these are new. This guy's new. These two guys here are new. And the two snipers, they're new. I had them, and I wanted to incorporate them into the story. excuse me. But the rest of the fellows, I had, like I said, a bunch of tank riders that were going to go here and a bunch of tank riders that were going to go there. I painted those back in the day when I was converting from enamels to acrylics. And the, I wasn't so good at it. So, stripping them really wasn't something that I could do without badly damaging the figures. There wouldn't be much left, I don't think. I think a lot of the detail was either eaten off during the painting process or would be eaten off during the cleaning process. So I don't think they'd fare well. And there's a lot of them, so it would probably just be easier for me to buy new ones. But that would defeat the purpose of the whole diorama, and that's reusing old stuff. So I decided, you know what, I have to decide, you know, here's the line. Some of these are going to go in the garbage, some of these aren't. So they went in the garbage. There's about 11 of them. I just decided that they're a lost cause, so they're gone now. But these guys I kept, and the scene overall I'm quite pleased with. I like the way it turned out. The overall story, the overall presentation and everything, I kind of like the way it turned out. I did all kinds of new stuff on this that I'd never done before, and a lot of it worked out better than I hoped, so that's always a good thing. I guess as a whole, I'm quite pleased with it. I had to slow down on it for a while there, because there were so many figures on it and everything. It kind of sucks the mojo a bit, so I kind of stopped. And then the Kursk group build started up, so that kind of slowed me down and sidetracked me. But then I came back to it there the other day, and I finished off the last of the figures that I wanted to do and installed them and then called it done. So it's going on the shelf now, and I think that's about it. I can't think of anything else I wanted to say about it. So, but this is going to be the last big diorama that I do for a while. I have one more planned for later in this year. One that Seb Schulf put me onto. He kind of dared me to do it, actually. So, I want to see if I can try and pull it off. But first I have to figure out if I got a place where I can put it when it's done. Right now I don't have anywhere to put it. It's actually going to be about the same size as this one. Maybe slightly bigger, but roughly, but it'll be higher and like off the screen. Maybe twice as high as this. Maybe not. Yeah, probably about as high as that. Yeah, it'd be about right about there, I guess. So quite big, and so I don't know if I have places for this kind of thing yet. So I have to sort through what I have behind me on the shelf already and see what's got to go and what's going to stay before I do anything about it. By the way, this is going to be the largest one I do for a while. And probably going to be a little while before I start another armor project. The Curse Group build is going on right now, and I just finished my first entry into it. My second entry will be probably in another couple of weeks I'll start that. I've only just started planning it, so I'm not ready to start building it yet. The in the meantime, I'm working on an airplane that I want to start. Wonderful Edward kit, Hellcat Mark II. Actually, it's a Mark I and a Mark II combo kit, one of the Pro V packs. And I wanted to build one of those things, those Pro V packs, for a while. And my buddy Nigel Wells put me onto this kit. And yeah, I was not disappointed. I'm not an aircraft builder by any means, but the holy crap, this is a super kit. And it wasn't expensive either. Wow. I've only ever built one other Edward airplane kit, and I was seriously disappointed by it. I thought it was a piece of crap. And I thought, I don't think I'm ever going to build another one of them. But I told Nige which one it was, and he said, yeah, that's not one of their best. It's not even one of their originals. He said, told me, try one of their original kits. You'll be much more impressed. So I tried this one here, and I saw what he did with it, and it was astonishing. So I'm going to try. It won't be anywhere near as good as his, but it's a good skill builder for me anyway. So I'm going to try and stick to as many airplane building principles as I can and try to ignore my armor impulses while building it, which is kind of the point. So it'll be a good teaching tool for me. And it looks, so far from what I'm looking at, it's not a quick build. It's a good build, but not a quick build, which is good. That's what I want. I want something interesting, and it looks like it's going to be. So, but anyway, enough jabbering on about all that crap. I got a slideshow for this thing, if any of you guys are still watching. There's also all the pictures from the slideshow are posted on my Facebook page if you want to look at it there, and a photo album for this build, so you can look at it there. That's all I got. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.
I gave an Oreo to my neighbor while she's hanging her clothes, just to brighten her whites or even brighten her smile. Maybe she might pass one over the fence to the lovely old man who loves a song and a dance. And when the flavors explode in his bones, oh, oh, it's magic. It's not that hard to give a little love, to share a little love around. It's not that hard to pass a little care. It's a big world out there, we all just need to know it's wonderful. I wonder if I gave an Oreo to the driver taking people back home, would he change his mind and maybe go for a drive to the beach? Or even pass that love to the girl on the bench who makes eyes with a boy who walks over and then shares a slice of joy. Why wonderful things can unfold, oh boy. It's not that hard to give a little love, share a little love around. It's not that hard to pass a little care. It's a big world out there, and we all just need to know. You can taste love at first bite, and if you share it, you just might remember. It's wonderful. This world is wonderful. Wonder if I gave an Oreo to my neighbor while she's hanging her clothes, just to brighten her whites or even brighten her smile. Maybe she might pass one over the fence to the lovely old man who loves a song and a dance. And when the flavors explode in his bones, oh, oh, it's magic. It's not that hard to give a little love.